Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to use Shutterstock CreativeFlow Plus. Now, when Shutterstock reached out to me about making this video, I was a little skeptical because I really love using Illustrator and Photoshop to create my social media images. But after I dug into the tool, I found there are a lot of really great benefits. So there are a couple reasons that you might want to use this tool. First, if you or your company has a subscription to Shutterstock, and actually for me, the last two places I worked at had a subscription, then this tool is free for you to use. If you don't have a subscription, you will have to pay a monthly fee to use this tool. But there is a free trial, and you can get a link to that in the description below. Second, most of us are pretty busy as graphic designers. I know my social media person would sometimes come up to me and need graphics really soon for the social media accounts. And this would have been perfect for that because there are already templates made that you can use easily and knock things out really quickly. It can also be really useful for a small business owner who doesn't really have the money to hire a graphic designer and also does not have time to learn Illustrator and Photoshop and graphic design theory. So this is sort of a workaround for them. Now I want to tell you a little bit about the free trial. This is good for a calendar month. So I think you would want to start it at the beginning of the month and then it would go through to the end of the month. Now it's also a little different because most free trials, they will go to the end of the trial and then charge you. But this free trial charges you 2 days before it ends. So if you're thinking about canceling, you need to know that. Make sure you jot it down in your calendar. And another thing to know is if you do decide to cancel it, you will still have access to all the designs you made, but you just can't edit them anymore. All right, let's jump into CreativeFlow Plus. Okay, so I'm here at the CreativeFlow landing page, and this just tells a little about everything it can do. We can create a design over here, but I will say that if you don't have the free trial or other access to CreativeFlow, like a subscription to Shutterstock, you can't actually use the design you create with these tools. So I think these tools just exist so you can see how they work without subscribing. So this tool has a background remover, a smart resizer, and then sort of a smart search that's powered by artificial intelligence that'll give you the best templates for your industry and audience. Now, if you use CreativeFlow, if you don't have the Shutterstock plan, if you just are using the free trial, you won't have access to all the content on Shutterstock. Like if you go to shutterstock.com and you're searching in there, you don't get access to all that. But you do get unlimited access to some starter content that's available inside the tool. But if you want access to everything, including all the images on Shutterstock, you'll have to get a subscription to Shutterstock. And there's some various options with Shutterstock of how many assets you get and that kind of thing per month. After you have your free trial set up and you've logged in, you'll still be on that same landing page. Now we have a button that says Try Create, and we'll click that one. So this will bring us to this page, which is really similar to the setup if you haven't started the free trial. But if you have the free trial, you can actually use the images you create. Okay, so I'm going to choose Facebook post right here. And this will kind of give me a blank canvas. Now, there are a lot of different things we can use here. We can get an image, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And I'm just going to choose this woman. If we click that, it'll put it on the screen. And then I'll just use the handles to kind of make it bigger and fill the space. Now up here we have a lot of little buttons that we can use. We can remove the background, and this is one that is so useful in my opinion. So I'm gonna click that. It might take a little time, but it does a really great job of removing the background. We can also adjust this image. We can change the exposure, the colors, we can sharpen it. There are a lot of different things we can do here to make our image a little different. There are pro effects, and these kind of give it a more artistic look. Then we've got effects that are more like filters here. We can add a drop shadow or different types of shadows and outlines here. And we can even animate. And these kind of work like PowerPoint. We can even add texture overlays. For example, if I come over here to glitter, she could be completely covered in glitter if that's what we wanted. I'm gonna go ahead and cancel. And then of course you can crop the layer by bringing in the handles like this. And I'll just crop it to match her size a little bit. And we'll apply that. We can also have her fade into the background or fade into another picture with this. Now over here on the left, we have some more options. We've got text, I'm just going to add this script text and it'll add them to the center. And you can click one, hold shift and select more, and then just put them up where you want them to be. We also have a layers panel here in the bottom right. So if I click this, you can see each layer. Now it's going to be a little hard to tell because these are so thin, but these three are our text layers and here is our woman. And then this is the background. Now I can change the background by clicking on this bottom layer and then I think I'll make it yellow. That looks good. To edit the text, I'm going to click and then double click in here and then I can type. And I'll just type, hello friends. I'm going to select all with Command A or Control A. We can increase our size here. I'm going to choose 400 or maybe 200. That looks pretty good. I'm going to double click on my subhead. I'll just type a little bit of text here and I'll get right on the edge here and just move this down a little bit. And for the body, I'll type some information about this event. And I could kind of center it a little better. I'm going to make this line up here just a little bigger. And that looks good. Now we also have shapes right here. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to choose the square and it'll put it right in the middle of my screen. And then I'm just going to resize it so it's a kind of a bar that goes behind Join Me. And if you find you're accidentally clicking on things, you can use your layers and select things that way. You can see it goes right over the top of her, so I can click and drag this layer to the top. I think I want to change the color of my bar. So to do that, I'll come up here to change color, and then this will open, and I can kind of hover on a color that I want. That looks good. I'm going to pull this below Join Me. And then I'm going to double click in here, select all with Command A or Control A, and then we'll change this to white. Okay, and I'm pretty happy about this. So at this point, I can download this as a Facebook post. So I'll choose download, and here I can choose a file type. I have three options here. I'm going to choose the JPEG. Quality is high. That's what we want. You'll probably always want to choose high here, and then choose download. And now it's on our desktop and we can upload this straight onto Facebook. Okay, so I'm done with this one. I'm going to come up here to File and Close. And when I do that, you'll be able to see it down here in your recent designs. Now for this next design, I'm going to show you how to use a template to create it, which is a lot easier than trying to come up with the design like I did with this one. So let's scroll down a little bit and you can see featured templates right here. And I'm going to do an Instagram post and I'm liking this design here. So I'll choose that and I'll choose customize this template. Now for this image, I want to kind of showcase a makeover that I did for my salon, for example. So I'm going to choose the background and then I'll choose textures. I'm going to go with glitter. And this looks good. Now I'm going to get on text. And when I do that, it'll ask me if I want to apply glitter. So I'll say yes, apply. And then I'm going to select my style text and I'll double click it. And then I'll type glam and I'm going to put makeover down here. Now I want to change this picture out to a photo of a woman that I did a makeover for. I'm going to get into my layers and see what we've got. I want to replace this image. So I'm going to select it. Then I'll come over here to images and I'll search for beautiful woman. Now, normally I would upload my own image here, but this woman here is perfect. So I'm going to click that. You can see it's put her up here at the top of the layer. So I'm going to click and drag this to put it where the other one was. And then I'll click that one, choose these three little dots, and then hit delete layer. Okay. So now we need to crop this image. I'm going to move it over just a little bit. I'll make sure I'm on the right layer and then I'll come up here to crop layer. Then I'll just bring this in. And then I can click on a different layer for it to take the crop, if that makes sense. So it looks like I missed this little piece down here. I'll click it again, I'll crop it again, and then just bring this up a little bit. And this looks good. So now I'm going to go ahead and download this piece. We'll do this one as a PNG image and I'll choose download. And now we'll close this file. So I'll come up here to File, Close. And this will take us back to this screen. Now there's one more thing I want to show you. Let's look at a few of these templates. Let's go with Facebook page cover. And there's this really cool collage tool right down here at the bottom. And you can choose how you want your photos to be laid out. Let's scroll down here a little bit and we'll choose this one. And now you can just drop your new images in here and there will be white space between each one. So I'll get in here on this first cell and I'll find the layer over here and then I'll choose these three dots and replace the image here. And we'll go from stock photos. I'm just gonna type in tech here and I think I like this one. We'll put that one in and add image. Now when you do it that way, it will automatically kind of crop it into the shape. So that's really nice. Let's go ahead and do another one. You can also click and drag these and it just moves it around inside that shape. So that's really nice. It's just like having a clipping mask. And I'll go ahead and fill in the rest of these so you can see the final result. Okay, so at this point, I can go ahead and download the image. I'll choose JPEG and high quality and download. And this is our result. Now, because we're using images from within CreativeFlow, we don't get watermarks. But if you want to use Shutterstock images and you don't have a subscription, you would see watermarks on these. Okay, now this predict area here, it helps you figure out which specific creative decisions will pay off for your future campaigns. And this is because of data-backed insights and intelligence that Shutterstock has found. But right now, this predict system only takes into account your design goals. So I'll kind of show you what I mean. Let's say you want to make something for Facebook. I want to do a post. I want my marketing objective to be, we'll say brand awareness. And then the business I want to promote, we only have six options here. And these are the only ones you can choose right now. But version 2 is coming out in January of 2023, and they do plan to add a lot more here. So let's say we're going to do finance. And then next, I'll choose images. Now here we can upload or search for images. So I'm going to choose add images. And instead of uploading, I'm going to do stock images. And I want to do Bitcoin. So I'll just choose that. Now this is an AI powered search. So when you search for something like Bitcoin, it's going to find the imagery that's predicted to perform the best for your audience and your objectives that you just put in a minute ago. So I'm going to choose a few of these pertaining to my goals for this post. Okay, that looks good. So we'll add those to predict. Now, when we enter these images, they're supposed to work with our goals that we input. And then CreativeFlow will give us some recommendations about what templates are going to be the best for our audience. So the templates that it thinks are going to do the best to generate interest in our brand are these templates. Now these images we uploaded, they don't currently make a difference for what templates we get down here, but starting in January, these images will help users get the best templates for their brand. Now also coming in January, Shutterstock is going to be rolling out color palette recommendations in the predict section too, and those should also help users get even more direction on how to compile images, templates, and colors into a unique and highly performing design. Now, once you have your designs created, I'm going to go back to our catalog. And these are all the images that we've used and the templates we've created. You'll remember I sized this one for Instagram, but let's say we decide we want a Facebook one too. Let's say we wanted to feature this image on our Facebook cover. So I can go back into this design, choose edit, and then come down here to smart resize. And we can change this image to automatically work for other platforms like Facebook. Let's choose a Facebook event cover. And it automatically resizes it. Now, sometimes it'll actually take this texture and make it go all the way out to the edges, which is really nice. So I'm going to choose copy and resize. I'll choose edit new image. And I can just click on this background and expand it to meet the Facebook specs. And then we could download this as a JPEG. So this smart resizer is really nice because it automatically has all the sizes built in. So you don't have to go looking for, you know, the size of a Facebook cover, for example. Let's try Pinterest. And we'll try a Pinterest pin. So you notice here it's actually resized the background. Didn't resize this though. So we can open up our layers and select those. I'm holding Shift to select multiple ones and then resize it, holding Shift. And then we could download this as a Pinterest image. Now there's one more thing that I wanted to mention, and that is the image converter. The image converter is a separate tool. I'm going to come out here to shutterstock.com/file-converter. And here we can drag and drop an image. We can upload our own, and then it will automatically convert to whichever file type we want. And so this is just a little extra tool that they have for absolutely free. And then you can download the new file. So that's CreativeFlow and how it works. It's super useful if you just want to knock out a lot of different sizes of graphics using templates that are already created for you. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you next week with another video. Thank you.